Hello students, welcome to this new lesson. Today you're going to learn about a fascinating art movement called Fauvism. In fact, it's all about colors. To understand Fauvism, you have to consider which art movements existed before. The major art movement that preceded Fauvism was Impressionism. Impressionism focused on outdoor painting to capture the changing daylight using short and quick brushstrokes. The focus is on realistic pictorial representation through forms and color. Later on, artists enjoyed a greater freedom to express their ideas and feelings. They abandoned the classical art styles of the past and invented new ones. One example of such artist is Georges Seurat, who explored color through pointillism. Themes also changed. Here, Edgar Degas observed and painted ballet dancers in movement. He made a series of quick sketches to capture ballet steps. Vincent van Gogh painted his room in a unique expressive style using heavy brushstrokes. We will see these types of brushstrokes during the period of Fauvism too. Paul Cézanne made different interpretations of the Mont Saint-Victor, which is found in France. A careful observation of this painting clearly indicates that his painting style is moving towards cubism. Now let us consider another famous artist of the post-impressionist period. Paul Gauguin believed that color has the power to reveal a range of emotions. In the Vision After the Sermon, the red color of the background is highly symbolical. It is said that Fauvism has its roots in the post-impressionist paintings of Gauguin. After this brief intervention on art movements, which existed as a result of more freedom acquired by artists, let us have a look at Fauvism itself. Many artists form part of this movement, but the credit for establishing Fauvism goes to Henri Matisse, an influential Fauvist artist. He made a series of still life compositions in the pure Fauvist painting style. In Dishes and Fruits, he used shades of expressive colors, especially in the foreground and the background. As we can see, the way colors were used is the driving force of Fauvism. This term was coined after that an art critic called the artist the Fauve, which literally means wild beast. Matisse developed a major concern in Fauvism when he was staying in Collioure together with his friend André Derain. The landscape was so inspiring due to the brightness of light that he explored and used vibrant and pure colors extensively in his paintings. Matisse also painted a scene of Collioure viewed from an open window, which was a new pictorial approach at that time. He was able to create depth through perspective in this painting. Boats appear smaller in the Bay of Collioure, and the line of horizon is shown in the distance. Flower pots are bigger to the viewer. Lines for each window frame also appear to converge to vanishing points. Look at this painting carefully. A classical painter would have never painted a figure with green color. But Matisse simplified his drawings to give more space to an exaggerated color scheme. There is also an intelligent combination of complementary colors that allow more contrast within the whole painting. For Matisse, it was more important to show emotions through color rather than details in an artwork. Progressively, he focused more on the simplest possible pictorial arrangement. He wrote, I quote, "Details lessen the purity of lines. They harm the emotional intensity, and we choose to reject them." At this point in time, color held no more a descriptive role in artworks. A new meaning was given to it. It reveals emotions. Matisse used simplified shapes in an almost childlike manner. This artwork is highly decorative and very expressive in terms of drawings and striking colors used. Let us now look at the works of another Fauvist painter, André Derain. Like Matisse, his drawings are quite simple, and yet this artwork is full of movement. We can see how busy activities are carried out in this harbour in London. Perspective is also very present here, as objects appear smaller when far away, and colours also fade in the distance. Observe the interplay of warm and cool colours in this painting. His services were required to make a series of paintings in London. A view of the London Bridge is painted with many details, but this painting also depicts a well-animated scene. Swirls in the water explain the movement of boats, while people on the bridge are enjoying the view of the pool of London. But what strikes us most is the subtle and intelligent combination of complementary colors used. Another characteristic of Fauvism is the depths of color artists use. This practice has probably been borrowed from movements which existed before. The way color has been applied for the ground evokes a sense of dynamism, as brush strokes create movement. Let us have a look at a few more paintings of Derain. Another famous Fauvist artist is Maurice de Vlaminck. His style was quite different from that of Derain, and he also had a different color palette. But there was the same interest for color rather than form. For the fields, he used large brushstrokes in addition to expressive colors. These are aspects of his artistic influence, for he was very close to Vincent van Gogh during his formative years as an artist. Similarly, for French houses, Maurice de Vlaminck use dark strokes as outlines, something that reminds us of Van Gogh's style of painting, though pure colors have been used here. Let us have a look at some more paintings of Vlaminck. We have just seen artworks of three main artists of the Fauvist movement: André Derain, Henri Matisse, and Maurice de Vlaminck. All three artists were good friends. Each one made a portrait of the other. Though they showed the same enthusiasm towards Fauvism, it is interesting to note that they had individual painting styles. Now, we'll look at other famous artists who were very active in this movement. Raoul Dufy, Georges Rouault, Albert Marquet, Georges Braque. All these artists were very close friends. They all had the same passion for pure colors. Well, students, we have just seen how colorful and powerful Fauvist artworks are. I hope you will now show beautiful colors in your paintings too. We'll end here. Thank you for watching. See you soon for another lesson.